okay? This is about effort, intensity, desire. All the toughest, all we can't give you. If you ain't born with you can't buy at Walmart. I'll see y'all tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock, all right? Let's go. Right up.
Come inside.
All right, how you doing?
Hey, family,
I'm
in family,
I'm doing 1, 2, 3.
Family.
Get your touches. Go down. Go. Yeah, that is what happened. That's a lot of people was asking that question. We had a couple of investigations about our basketball program here at W.T.White, and probably because of the success that we've had over the last couple of years, someone sent some anonymous emails about we were recruiting and everything. So that's kind of what started it, and our district has a policy that anytime someone brings up allegations against you, they have to definitely look into it. So, and I understand that now, you know. It broke me. I can admit that now. It broke me. I had a lot of sleepless nights. Up until the hearing, I had sleepless nights every night. I was literally, you know, going to bed at 11, 1130, waking up at 3. Between 3 and 4 every morning. Saturdays and Sundays too, before going to church and everything, I was waking up just walking around my house and, you know, just upset that, you know, that the kids and their families had to go through this and then I had to go through with it. And then, you know, I had to gather myself and get back on track with my guys, the kids, you know, which is important to me. And I often tell people this, I think I have the best coaching staff in the whole country, because a lot of times when I was in my office doing mounds and mounds of paperwork, trying to make sure that we got everything correct and all I's dotted, all T's crossed, all statements correct, you know, my coaches were still in the gym, you know, putting the guys through the rigor and practicing and working them out and everything. So. If it had not been for them, it would have been really, really different. It would have been way worse than what it was.
Like, dang, ain't no way this happened.
Yeah.
It's like, I ain't expect to sit out. I thought it was good.
Yeah.
I was like, unknown. So like, I don't know like how that could happen to me of all people. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was like, really hit me for real.
Yeah.
So like, the only thing I remember is getting off the bus and them telling us we was late and had to hurry. And then after that, just blank. Just me waking up in the car on the way to like ER.
What?
Yeah, what I was told, like I was going up for a dunk and the kid went under my legs. And I actually got the video. And I actually hit my head on the ground, like really got like bounced up. I think I was knocked out. So like, yeah, I had to sit another 3 games because the concussion really sent me back. So coming back to the Hillcrest game, I don't think I was like still all there. It's probably the worst game I played all season.
Horns down.
crowd, probably the loudest crowd we had all season. Yeah. Their opposing crowd, like, really messed with us as a team. It was like, we ain't never seen nothing like that before. Yeah, like, none of us really experienced like that. Like, my first game back, I have no rhythm, can't hit nothing, can't really do anything. Really feel like I was just out there for real.
Check it.
We were up about this game. We knew for sure we were going to go in here and dominate, and it was not going to be close. And after we lost that game, it just seemed like our whole world had sunk. I know me and Coach Williams was on the bus, and we were just complaining and just talking about how bad we are and how this season was not going to be what we thought. And Coach Pat just had a moment where he just kind of snapped on us and was telling us, like, hey, man, I don't want to hear that kind of stuff, man. We're gonna have to really coach these jokers.
As I told y'all, in the fall, that we was gonna have to coach these kids anyway, because it was a group of kids that had never played varsity basketball before. So I said, we gotta coach them. We're gonna have to coach them this year. So I said, so that's what we gotta do right now. Let's coach them and let's see what happens. So
been told, first quarter, if you win the first quarter, win the third quarter, you usually win the fourth quarter. Then you usually win the game. Okay? We're 1-0 right now. We're 1-0. So let's go capitalize on Friday game against SOC. Better team, better talent, not better coaches, not better players. But we're going to have to play. All the energy going to be there. Everybody going to be in there. It's going to be rough. It's going to be crazy. Nothing else, we gotta come out of there with a mother flipping win.
Hey, and
that's the bottom freaking line.
Position to be successful, and they were able to learn how to play, you know, not only with each other but for each other. So you could literally see in games them starting to figure things out, and when they started to do that, we knew that we were going to be pretty formidable for people.
uplift each other and be happy and excited when things are going well. Mm-hmm. Tonight was a well night. I just challenge y'all to continue it when things not going so well. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have those moments. But sometimes in games, like you come back just because y'all together.
Yeah, we're nothing without each other.
District. Right now we're sitting at 4-0. The second half of district, we had a lot of moving pieces in the first half of district, but right now we're just trying to win one game at a time. I think the way that the guys are gelling right now is what we had ideal. You know, during the Christmas break we wanted to be there, but you know, not having some players there, we didn't get to do that. But now we gelling and we moving in the right direction, trying to head into the playoffs, fighting for that third or fourth spot. I'm just excited to be now playing for the playoffs. And that's what we're trying to do right now. Because when we get to the playoffs, it's 0-0. The records don't matter. You gotta come play.
Yeah.
after the ball. That is the difference in us having a blowout win right now. Guys, execute the freaking play. Let's score on this right here, okay? All right? Let's get us another, what, 6-point quarter?
Yes, yeah, 6-point quarter.
Guys, let's get another 6-point quarter, man. Let's get some.
Big brother and get smacked around a little bit. You know, we built this gym, we letting them borrow it, but God is good, and so is W.T.White basketball.
Say, man, it's personal, okay? This, you see all this in here?
We like that.
Let's take a nice little view of that gym right there. None of that possible without Pete Dub, myself, and everybody else that came up under him, man. So, personal tonight. And we had to show they really not like that, and we really like that. We really like
Hey, make sure youngest player on the team forgot his shoes.
That's the first time in 9 years.
K made up.
That's all right. But you got
hey, you
your
on varsity now, though.
There's no excuse.
Go ahead on JV. Hey,
no excuse.
Let's go. What are you going to do?